Hi, I'm Alex, and together with my friend Drew, we make Agenda, a date-focused note-taking app that allows you to be in control of the many things going on in your life and stay on top of everything that's important to you. It helps you to be much more organized and lets you be much more productive and creative by freeing up your mind. This is why I think you should be using Agenda. Now let me show you the way it achieves all of this and how it works. Like I said, Agenda is a date-focused note-taking app. You can use it like any other generic note-taking app, but one of its strengths is that you can assign a date or link a calendar event to your notes. Now I hear you say, oof, that sounds like for very serious work, like for people that are working from cubicles and are in back-to-back meetings, you know, that's not for me. But wait, it is for you, because if you think about it, a lot of the things that are going on in our lives are ultimately tied to either a date or linked to some event. For instance, the birthday party from your mom that you need to organize, or your next family doctor's appointment, the summer holiday plans, or the blog post you want to write next week. Almost everything we do ultimately gets tied to some date and some time. This is how we organize ourselves. That's what determines our day. This is how we determine what's on our agenda. An agenda works perfectly fine without dates, and you don't have to assign one if it doesn't make any sense. For some things, a date might just not be very relevant. You know, like the stuff you need to buy for the house, or a list of ideas for your podcast, your Wednesday evening hobby projects, or a list of cool places to visit the next time you have a weekend off. But still, I mentioned Wednesdays already again, and some weekend away in the future, so a lot of these things ultimately do become tied to a date, and when this happens, you can just assign it in Agenda. You know, from that list of cool places, you pick one for the Easter break. Or from your bucket list that says scuba diving in tropical waters, you decide that that's going to happen this summer. Well, you better want to be prepared. And usually this means sorting out a hotel, buying gear, making a list of things or places you want to visit. And all of that you can do in a new note in Agenda and assigned to the date that that will take place. Now, why is that useful? Well, because it's a great way to find back stuff. You know, in a sea of information we create and we keep track of, it's sometimes really hard to find back things. But dates are something that we always remember, that we're organized by, like I said. So you know when the date of your birthday from your mother is. You know when that Easter break was when you went to some cool place, or the summer that you went scuba diving for the first time. It gives things a logical mental place in your mind, which is super useful if you try to remember something in the middle of all the information we have to deal with. Having a place like Agenda, where you can write down all your ideas, the things that have happened, and your thoughts, and knowing that you can instantly find them back if you need to, is exactly what gives you this feeling of being organized, being in control and on top of things. And ironically, this is also exactly the thing you sometimes need to disconnect, to zoom out and step back from the things that kept you busy all day. You know this feeling when you go to bed and just as you lay down, you get this great idea and somehow this keeps you busy all night, it all wakes you up again? Well, this is exactly when you need something like Agenda just to put it down, to write it down and knowing that you can find it back the next day there. Now I know that many of you might actually have a little notebook next to their bed for exactly this reason. Or walk around with a pocket agenda, which, no surprise, is where the name Agenda came from. But the problem with paper is that it's static and that you can't easily find things back. And dozens of post-its everywhere is also not a great solution. But most of all, it doesn't allow you to evolve your ideas easily. And this is what Agenda is all about. Now, enough with all the talking. Let me give you an example of how this all comes together in Agenda. Here we are in Agenda looking at some notes that might seem familiar to you. All notes in Agenda belong to a project, and in this case it's my ideas project. On the left, here in the sidebar, you see all the projects that I have, grouped by a number of categories like my personal projects, work projects, hobbies and family, But this is all up to you, how you divide your notes over projects and categories. But don't worry too much in the beginning. It will develop by itself into the perfect system that works for you. So here's my bucket list that I mentioned earlier. And I've decided that I want to go scuba diving in tropical waters, finally. But of course, there's a lot involved with scuba diving. So let's create a new note using the plus button here on the top, where I keep track of the things that I need to do for scuba diving. And as time progresses, I'm adding my notes. What courses do I need and where do I do this? You know, what equipment do I need? I can make lists of items that I need to buy. I can put in web links, tables, I can attach files, I can do photos. And as I dive into this new adventure, I have a place where I can put all my notes, answer all the questions, keep track of everything that I need to get started. Now let's fast forward a bit, and in the meantime I've answered many of my questions. As you can see, this note has grown quite a lot. I know exactly which equipment I need. And next week's my first lesson of the paddy course in the local swimming pool. So maybe it's time to jump in the deep and let's convert this note into a project. What I'll do is I'll create a new project called scuba diving under hobbies. And I'll move my note into there. At the same time, now that I know all the gear that I need, let's just extract that into a separate note. So that's a lot better. And while we're at it, let's just split off all this information on the destination in a separate note as well. Now, like I said, my first scuba diving lesson is coming up soon. Look, I have it already booked into my calendar. Now, the cool thing about Agenda is that everything in your calendar is also available in Agenda. If you open the inspector on the right, you can see that your calendar is there, including all your appointments. And there's my diving lesson. Now, I'm an eager student, so I want to be totally prepared. So all I have to do is simply drag this event in here and it will create a note for me linked to this event. So when you do this, you'll notice a number of things have happened. First, the date of the event is now shown in the note. Second, the event itself has gained this note icon. If I click on that, I will be brought directly to my notes for this event. And finally, if we now look in the calendar app, you can see that the event itself has now also a link to Agenda. Now remember that I said that we associate things to dates and events? Well, all you have to do now is click on the link in the event and boom, you're back to your notes. Now similar to how Agenda integrates with the calendar, it also integrates with the Reminders app. For example, looking at this list of gear that I need to get, I can easily add a reminder for myself to pick this up next Thursday. This reminder is then added to the Reminders app, so I'm sure I won't forget to pick it up. And as you dive into this new adventure, your project evolves with you. You start by recording all your lessons until you get to your first dive. And at some point you might even create a separate project with a log of all your dives. And for sure you're going to start this new note that where you collect all these great diving locations which you'd like to visit next. Which sounds a lot like that weekend away, right? And this is a pattern that comes back all the time. Something that starts small as a list of ideas, grows into a separate note or maybe even a project over time, with various notes associated to all kinds of events and dates. And this is what Agenda is great for. It gives you this place where you can find things back, or what happened, how you got to some place, but also where you can store ideas for the future. And this is with you all the time, because Agenda syncs all your notes through all your devices, like your iPhone and your iPad, but also all your Macs, at work or at home. In this video, there is not enough time to go through everything Agenda can do. We'll have other videos for that too, on our channel. But at least it gave you hopefully some ideas of how the app works, but more importantly, what the philosophies are behind it. And maybe it already gave you some ideas of how you could use Agenda for your projects. So how do you get started? First thing to do is of course to download Agenda from agenda.com, our website, or from the app stores. You'll find the links in the description to the video. Now, if you're new to Agenda, be sure to check out the next video, which gives you a number of tips to get you going quickly. Now, that's it for this video. I hope you're giving Agenda a try, and I can't wait to hear how you're getting on and what impacts Agenda makes for you. I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.